Hi, good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Como Live, funded by the Legacy Amendment. Today I'm in our Tropical Encounters exhibit, and I'm here to talk to you about the largest snake that we have on exhibit at Como Park Zoo and Conservatory, and that is Xena. She is our green anaconda. So we'll give you guys a little view of her, but I'll talk about her a little bit too. Xena, like I said, she's a green anaconda. She is 19 years old, and she originally came to us from the Pittsburgh Zoo, but she has been here a little while. Now, it's kind of hard to see the length of her as she's all kind of crunched up in the water, but also her head is on land too. I want you, when you're looking at her, to think about maybe how long she is. Just think about it for a second. Make a guess how long you think Xena might be. So we estimate that Xena is about 17 feet long, maybe 18. It's hard to know exactly. It's not like we stretch her out. It's not good for them and measure her. But we do guess she's about 17 feet long, which is crazy. So green anacondas can get to be 29 to 30 feet long when they are fully grown. So that's about the length of a school bus, to put it into perspective and to give you something to compare it to. So that is a very large snake. She is among one of the largest snakes in the world. So with the Burmese python and the green anaconda, they're both pretty comparable in size. So green anacondas are part of the boa family. They're aquatic boas. As you can see, she is kind of in the water here, and that is naturally what they would do in their wild habitat. So they're really good swimmers, and they would hang out in murky, stagnant, more shallow water, and that's where they would find their food. So they can hold their breath. If her head was underwater, she could hold her breath for about 10 minutes at a time if she wanted to. But most of the time, they would be hanging out under the water and waiting for small mammal prey to come. And that's when they would strike, and that's what they would eat. So they live in the rainforest, and they eat things like capybaras, agoutis, and other small mammals too. Like all boas, she is a constrictor. So that means she will wrap her body around her prey and squeeze it. And then they would swallow it whole. So she does not have venomous fangs like some other species of snakes might have. Here at Como, we would feed Xena. It's usually a large rabbit once every few weeks or so. But sometimes it's even less often than that. It really depends on the season and also how hungry she is. Snakes in general just don't need to eat as often as we do, or as other mammals do as well. So a really cool thing when you think about reptiles, you usually think that a lot of them are egg-laying animals. While Xena, the green anaconda, and other boas are different, they don't lay eggs. They have a type of reproduction which is called ovoviviparous, and you may have heard that word before if you've watched Como Live. Specifically, if you watched our presentation that one of our educators did on the skink, the blue-tongued skink, they're also ovoviviparous. But that's your vocabulary word for today. And what that basically means is if Xena had eggs, she would actually, the eggs would hatch inside her body, and then she would give birth to live babies. So a green anaconda mother has anywhere between 20 to 40 offspring at once, and those offspring are born, they're 2 feet long. So wrap your head around that. That's a lot of snakes. There's a bad pun too. Okay, so about 20 to 40, 2 to 4 foot long green anacondas. The mother loses about half her body weight after she gives birth, and those baby snakes pretty much can hunt and swim immediately after they're born. So pretty impressive. They don't have any parental care either. Now, we're in Tropical Encounters. Like I said, this is a rainforest habitat, and that's normally where you would find these snakes in the wild. They'd be found in South America. like many of our other plants or animals here. You may have heard of these species of snakes, green anacondas, Burmese pythons, maybe other large species of snakes living in the Everglades in southern Florida. And that is correct. They can be found there. However, they're not native. They're actually considered invasive. And they have been invasive there since the 1980s. So they're really detrimental to that habitat there because that's not normally where they would be found. The biggest native snake to Florida is the 9-foot-long eastern indigo snake. So these snakes are about 3 times the size as the biggest native snake in Florida. They outcompete other animals for food. They're a really big problem to the mammal population because that's what they're hunting. And they themselves are just physically destructive to the habitat down there just because of their size and they're so big. And they reproduce, they don't have any natural predators down there, and you can imagine not much is gonna go after a full-size green anaconda. And you're probably wondering then, well, you know, why are they there? How did they get there? And a lot of it has to do with people purchasing these snakes as pets and then deciding, oh, I don't want that snake anymore. Thinking of, hey, where's a good place? Where's a good home for this snake? And they think, okay, the Everglades, that's pretty similar to their natural habitat, so that'll be a good home. Well, obviously that's not the right answer, as you know, that can really have an effect on the entire ecosystem down there. But the Florida Fish and Wildlife is really trying to combat the numbers of the larger snakes that aren't native there. And they do this by basically having a open hunting season for them and seeing if people can hunt them. It's very difficult though, because like I said at the beginning of the talk, they hang out in murky water, they're really hard to find. Even though they're really big, they're very fast in the water. So unfortunately, you know, the hunting season for them has been proven to be a little bit unsuccessful, but there's still hope and they're still, you know, trying to control the snake populations in their non-native habitats. So it looks like she's moving a little bit right now, which is super awesome, because I will say I checked on her this morning and she was in this same spot. They just don't need to move very much. So it is kind of cool that you get to see her move around. And a lot of people come to Como and they ask, oh, can I see Xena get fed? And we don't really have a scheduled feeding time for her because she does eat more intermittently. So it is definitely a special treat when the zookeepers do put her food in. But like I said, she might not always eat it. But she does get, like I said, a rabbit every few weeks or so. So definitely when you come to Como, Como Zoo and the conservatory are open right now. So you can make a reservation to come see Xena in person. You just have to do that by visiting our website. She's a really cool snake to see and check out. And it's hard to see on the camera, but her size is really impressive, especially, you know, when you compare her to other snakes that you might find here in Minnesota. We just don't have any type of snake like her here. But I hope you learned a little bit about Xena. If you had any questions during this talk, if something comes up, you can definitely post them in the comments. And afterwards, I'll do my best to look at those and get back to you too. But thank you so much for listening to Como Live this afternoon. Have a great day.